Welcome to Ecto and Encounters with Michelle and Denise, brought to you by KBLP LLC and King's Cannabiz, and we'll be right back. Let me reiterate that. This is Planet B period O period B period. I am on the wrong day, guys. I am so sorry. You know, I almost put that in, too. Ecto and Encounters. I don't know what. It must be the cold meds making my mind mushy. I don't know what's going on. But this is Planet B.O.B. And we're going to be talking about tainted foods and food safety. So we'll be right back with that.
Just sleep, just dream. This isn't fair, no, we're not just what we see.
We won't find it, but I'll
boys and girls, London calling. Now don't look to us. Phony Beatlemania is putting the dust. London calling. See, we ain't got no swing except for the rain and the crunch of things. The ice is coming, the sun's zooming in. Meltdown expected, the wheat is going thin. Engines stop running, but I have no fear, 'cause London is drowning. I live by the river, to the imitation zone. Forget it, brother, you can go it alone. London calling, to the zombies of death. Quit holding out and draw another breath. London calling, and I don't wanna shout, but while we were talking, I saw you nodding out. London calling, see, we ain't got no hide, except for that one with the yellowy eyes. The ice age is coming, the sun's zooming in. Engines stop running, the wheat is going thick. A nuclear error, but I have no fear, 'cause London is drowning.
And welcome to Planet B.O.B. Hi, Michelle.
Hey, guys. How you doing?
And as you can tell, yes, I have a summer cold. I'm dying here. At least I feel like it. So she's going to do most of the talking tonight, I think. So, have
at it. Probably. All right. Tonight we're talking about just a lot of the stuff that's been going on with the recalls of food, food safety, things like that, especially in the summer heat. A lot of people will take food to picnics or whatever, and they don't think about the safety, you know, foodborne illnesses, things like that. A lot of people don't realize, like potato salad, for instance.
Mm-hmm.
If you do not keep that chilled, even when it's sitting on the picnic table, you can get really sick.
Oh, yeah. That mayo turns so quick.
Ugh. Exactly. And why? Because it's got eggs in it.
Yep. And the mayo. Ooh.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Well the mayonnaise is made for me.
That's
true. A lot of people don't realize that. And,
And,
like, you can't, like, I've seen them where they'll take it in a cooler to the site, but then they'll leave it out on a hot table.
Yeah.
For, you know, an hour or two, and wonder why everybody just suddenly got sick.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. You can't do that. Absolutely not. Any food.
Especially these days. It's not like it was in the old days, people.
No.
I mean, so many foods, it's not just the products themselves. They have these processed crap in them to keep them, you know, good or whatever else, and it's like even those things, you don't know where their processing plant for this stuff is that's going in, you know, there's just so many things.
Yeah, absolutely.
So many things.
Yes.
And these recalls, what do you think about
these? Oh my God. Every time.
Like left and right.
Yeah, every time you turn around, there's something. What happened to quality control? We never had this problem before, ever.
Well, you think about when we were kids, there wasn't that many people on the planet. Now they have to feed so many people, and they're, you know, they're constantly growing year round, and this stuff, and they're processing it. But
I, you know, what I think, part of it is because people are not doing it. Too many robotics.
Yeah, that's true.
There's no, you know, in some place, in some plants, you have the robotics doing your packing and stuff for you, okay? So I don't think that the product quality control is there anymore.
Well, and it's, and people, a lot of stuff, things that people don't understand about recalls, too, is it doesn't mean that entire batch is bad.
Right, right, very true.
What it means is, okay, somebody in, you know, Timbuktu nowhere got sick after they ate the stuff, so they, you know,
they made a complaint, yes.
And there's, what did you eat? And they're telling them what they ate. So then, next thing you know, they're testing it, and like, and in the entire package of whatever they ate, they might have found a tiny piece of broccoli that had something on it. Well, then they have to go back and figure out where that batch came from. Then they have to put out the recall.
Right, exactly.
It's not something that they found it in 10 million things. Or,
no.
But, you know, it's not, but sometimes it is that. Sometimes it's, you know, 100 people got sick from eating the same thing.
Yeah. No, do you know what that, you know, the latest recall is?
What's that?
Fresh veggies from Trader Joe's and Green Giant Company.
Oh, yeah, that, yeah, I had posted that in the kit, yeah. Yeah, it's not all their vegetables. It's just,
no, it's just zucchini noodles.
Yeah.
The zucchini noodles to possible listeria.
But it wasn't the one, you know, it wasn't passed out all over the country. No. And like I said, again, it was just that certain batch.
Right, right. But we never had, you know, we never had recalls on food when we were growing up.
Sure there was. Sure there was.
Was
we
there?
Just didn't hear them. Oh, yeah.
Maybe. We just didn't hear it. That's true.
Well, we didn't have the internet telling us about it.
Oh, that's
it,
true,
know?
Too. That's very true.
We posted in a newspaper or put it on the nightly news.
I don't remember any, though.
You know, like, I can remember being a kid, and I can remember some apples, some frozen apples got recalled. Because it had something with aluminum got in them or something. I can remember that.
I don't remember anything.
It was like aluminum dust or something to that effect. But, I mean, it wasn't like every day like it is now.
Yeah, that's for sure. It's crazy. We recently had the frozen blackberries at Kroger.
In
Costco, we just had those. Let's see.
Yeah,
what was
that was E. coli, right?
Let me check. I think it was. But let me check here. Hepatitis A. How the hell do you get that in frozen?
Well, let me tell you a story. When I lived in California, this was back in the 80s, even, you know, late 80s. I can remember strawberries having to be recalled. Strawberries, I mean, that were sent all over the country had to be recalled. And what happened was, these poor farm workers were out in the middle of the fields, and these farmers were too cheap to put porta potties
out
of the fields, because the suggestion thing is to put, you know, certain ones. This is back when they still picked them by hand and everything, and these workers were doing their business, one and two, in the middle of the field.
Okay.
On the product.
Oh,
so
my God.
So they're being sent out, and even, you know, some of them get, you know, they do get.
Yeah.
Goes through a process, but if they even miss even a tiny bit, it's done.
Yeah, very true.
That's why it's very important, you know, you tell people this until you're blue in the face, but it's like, you have to wash your fruits and vegetables.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
The frozen one.
Oh, obviously. Hepatitis A, though?
It's
What the hell?
Well, sometimes it gets in the product because another thing, while stuff is growing, same thing.
Yeah.
It happens whether it's fertilizer or people are going in the fields and doing God knows what, you know. So,
You
also, this is another, I mean, it's a conspiracy theory and it's probably paranoia, but I mean, has anybody thought about the fact that maybe people are doing this on purpose?
Yeah, I thought about that.
To our stuff that gets processed. So it's like.
Yeah. They think it's funny or something. Oh, watch it.
Or even if it's like a terrorist type thing. You know what I mean? Like somebody going, I mean, you think about it.
Yeah, that's true. Could be.
I mean, you never know.
Yeah, that's true.
You never know. So it's like, and a big way to avoid this, grow your own food.
And there you go.
Grow your own vegetables. Learn how to can.
Yes, absolutely. It's a bit of work.
Saying this until we're blue in the face. Whether you can, or you freeze it yourself, or you want to freeze dry it, do it. If you can't grow your own, go to a farmer's market, somebody local, and get your fruits and vegetables. You know?
Yep, sure. Hepatitis A, though. Who'd have thought?
Wow. Well, it's very, like I said, you never know who's out in those fields. You just don't. And then you got these flash freeze processes where they go through like this, almost like a chemical wash. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah,
when they first get it out, they put it through that process and then they freeze it. And that's not all. Some of them will freeze them right from the field.
Yeah. Yep.
So think about that one for a minute.
Jeez.
Yeah.
There was a lot of that, most of it. Wow.
Yep, and then there was a while back, I think it was oatmeal? Was it oatmeal that was recalled? They thought there was plastic in it. No, that was the right new sauce.
Yeah.
The oatmeal had something else in it. That was a few years back. But recently, ragu had, you know, chunks of plastic in there. You know, they had to recall just a certain portion, but they thought there was chunks of plastic.
Well, there was chicken. I think it was in the late spring. Chicken. And it wasn't Tyson. I forget who it was. But they thought there were bits of wood.
Yeah.
Wood chips in it. Wood splinters in the chicken. I'm like, Jesus.
Now, this can be explained, though, because a lot of these companies, they can't afford to run these factories on just what they make.
Right.
They will make their product from, you know, X amount of days to X amount of days, and then they will rent out their factory to somebody else to do their whatever they're doing. Or maybe it's just a side company of theirs, and they're doing it there, too, and then they don't clean their equipment properly, and then next thing you know.
God, that I didn't know. Holy cow.
Yeah.
That's
it's true. Like they'll make different things at the one factory.
Yeah. Wow.
Then you've got to take in the factor. You know, there might be some asshole disgruntled factory worker somewhere.
Yeah.
That decides that he wants to throw a piece of wood in the mix. I mean.
Yeah, that's very true. Very true.
You just never know. Never know what's in your process.
It's just so sad that this is happening. You know, so often. Right before Memorial Day, that E. coli thing was, it was over 62,000 pounds of raw beef, brisket, short ribs, and ribeye steaks.
Yeah.
Yeah, right before Memorial weekend.
Yep, I remember that. I do remember that. And then there was something right before Christmas that one year, too, where people could, remember the romaine lettuce thing?
Yeah, that was like two or three times. They never, you know, they didn't get it the first time, so they recalled the next batch, and then there was another one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you know something, too, like we had mentioned the fact about when we were younger.
Yeah.
But you really think about it, there really wasn't anybody to really inspect this kind of stuff when we were younger, so it's like, it may have been getting us sick and nobody knew. You know, like all of a sudden you get some mystery stomach bug. When you're like, you know, 8 years old, you're like, oh, it must be something going around, you know, and in fact, it was your, you know, whatever TV dinner.
I don't know. I think they had more quality control, though. You know, they did have government inspectors coming in. Had to be inspectors.
But not like they didn't associate it. It wasn't really until, what the hell was that? Years ago, it happened years ago, like a Jack in the Box or something. Some kid got, you know, people were dying because they had like the uncooked burgers or whatever, and then they blamed the burger factory, which really cracked me up.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, that they blame the hamburger meat. Well, if these people would have cooked it thoroughly, it wouldn't have happened.
There you go. Yes.
You know?
Yeah.
But anyways, they blame that, and it was after that is when they explode. That's when they started, like, micro really watching, like all these companies, and then it just snowballed from there. It's like, now they got people that go in there with, like, these fine-tooth combs and, which is good, you know, I guess, but it's like...
obviously it's not doing much good.
Yeah, but it just cracks me up. You know, well, most of the time they go in there after something went wrong.
Yeah, it's after the fact.
Shitty, yeah. But that cracked me up with that whole deal when they were blaming the meat company.
Yeah, and it wasn't. Yeah, I remember that.
Well, no, there was actual there any meat, you know, like hamburger meat has, you got to cook it thoroughly.
Yeah, just because the outside's done doesn't mean the inside's done. They were almost like, you know, probably too high of heat. The outside was done, looked good.
It was, you know, to me, it wasn't the meat company's fault, but they're the ones that got blamed.
Yeah, of course. Of course. That's kind of like, you know, McDonald's coffee deal.
Okay. Well, that one now, I actually did research on that one.
Yeah.
McDonald's was 100% responsible because what happened, one of their burners malfunctioned.
Oh, did it?
And it superheated this coffee, and this elderly woman had put it, like, you know, like we all do sometimes, put it between your legs to do something, and it spilled. And what it did to her was insane.
What did it do? I know it burned her.
Oh, it wasn't just a burn. I mean, her skin was eaten away.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Like, flesh was falling off of her.
Oh.
And then she ended up with some kind of infection from it, and she had a surgery, and the pictures from it are just...
Oh, I'm going to have to check that out.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I used to think the same way as you, and then I did some research and found out, no, she deserved every damn penny she got.
Well, good for her, then. Well, there was several other ones, too, like on the foil. A lady cut her finger on the where you rip the foil off because of the teeth.
Oh, yeah.
That was stupid.
One's dumb. That one's
there was
dumb.
A lot of dumb shit. But
that coffee thing, though, definitely. Look that up. That
I'm
woman.
Going to. I got to see that.
Oh, God. It was horrible. Those pictures, I'm like, oh, yeah,
burner,
she deserved every bread set.
Basically, the coffee burner was malfunctioned.
Yeah, what happened was the burner, something happened with the burner, and it, like, superheated the coffee.
Yeah. Wow.
And I guess it was, like, it was boiling.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. That's crazy.
Yeah. So, and then when the lid came off and it spilled her, flesh was coming off.
Oh, God. Oh, I can't even imagine.
Yeah, so she, you know, and this is an elderly woman whose skin was compromised anyways.
Yeah. Oof. Oh, my God. Wow. Well, yeah, good for her then. Good, good, good.
Yeah. One of these days, you can go online and you can look up the pictures.
Yeah, I'm going to.
What, you know, oh, my God. It was like, oh, bleh.
Yeah. Well, we were talking about the Tyson chicken strips. That was in May. They had to recall almost 12 million pounds of frozen chicken strips contaminated with metal pieces.
Yep.
I include several types of frozen Tyson chicken strips, fully cooked strips, buffalo, and honey barbecue. They have the use-by dates. Of course, please look these products up if you have any of them. And check your use-by date.
Yeah, you can actually go online and look up the thing. It's like recall.
Yes.
And you can look up everything that's been recalled and then go through your cabinet.
Yeah. And there were three reports of injuries with this. So, 6 consumer complaints about metal pieces and 3 reports of injuries. So, there you go. Take them back, throw them out, whatever you got to do. Metal pieces. It's like, wow.
There was years ago, this was probably in the late 90s. Do you remember this? The pickle jars? People were drinking out of the pickle jars and the glass was coming off like in shards?
No.
Yeah, this was, I don't remember which pickle company it was, but there was actual, the something happened with the glass where they didn't do something. It was actually the jars themselves.
Ew.
And around the edges where the lid was going, it was putting glass pieces into the pickles.
Oh. I don't drink the pickle juice anyway, but, okay. But that's, oh.
Yeah, but a lot of people do. They'll take the lid off and start chugging it.
Ew.
Yeah, that was years ago. I don't remember which pickle company it was, but yeah.
Wow. I didn't know about this one, the Hunt's tomato paste.
I didn't either. What's with that?
Yeah. April. It's past April. Hunt's announced a recall of the small cans of no-salt added tomato paste. Some of the cans may have been damaged after the canning process. Could potentially have mold inside. Ugh.
Oh, hi.
Ugh. Gross. So, after the canning process, they may have been damaged. Really?
Yes, and right there it goes to show you, it may not be the product itself.
Yeah.
But, it's like these guys, they probably buy these cans from a place who makes cans. You know,
yeah,
and the can sucked.
Yep, absolutely. It's
like
a vicious circle.
The jar sucked. You know, it's like, so it may not be the product itself. It may be the thing that it's going into.
Yep, in this case, it was a can. Excuse me.
Bless you.
Thank you. Oh, out here it was the cans. Wow, mold. Great, yeah. March this year. Butterball ground turkey. Contaminated with salmonella.
Really?
Yes. Five people had gotten sick. So.
What made me really curious about this one is I ate the butterball ground turkey around April.
Oh, you got sick.
And I had gotten sick for 2 months.
Yes. Oh, it was a freeze-by date of July. But it was... What the hell?
But I didn't, you know.
Yeah. So
wouldn't they catch that on my blood work, though, if it was something like that?
I don't know, unless there's a separate test for that. I honestly don't know.
That's weird.
Yeah. The butterball ground turkey. Salmonella. Do you know about flour?
Sure, I don't
know. Pillsbury unbleached flour. Did you know about that? I didn't.
I didn't know about that.
When the hell is this? This is under April. Or March. March, I'm sorry. I think. Pillsbury unbleached all-purpose flour. Hometown Food Company announced a recall of the flour on March 8th. May have been contaminated with salmonella again.
Jeez Louise.
Yeah.
Well, the one thing with salmonella, though, is a lot of people don't know. Yeah, it can be passed off as like just some kind of stomach flu.
Yeah.
You know, if you're a healthy person, it's not going to affect you as bad as it would like a child or a person or somebody that's already compromised.
Yeah.
So, So we may have eaten this stuff and not even known it.
Yeah, very true.
But did you know that there's a certain amount, I'm sitting here reading it, that there's a certain amount of, like, different types of contaminants that are actually allowed in foods?
Oh.
Because the body can process it.
Good for us, but what is it?
Let's see, 0.00 cells, so it's like some trace amount. But still, it's just the fact that it's allowed in there.
But what's, you know, what if it compromises somebody who has cancer or something?
Well, apparently they think that it can fight it. And also human remains. Oh, my God.
Oh, now that's no, and no.
I'm going to read this stuff. It's like, how?
How could that even be part of anything?
I don't know if it's like skin or hair.
But... How can that even be good? I don't care. Oh, my God. Ugh. That's just... Oh, God.
This was this year that this came out.
What is the safe amount of human remains we can eat?
Again, it's like a 0.00 something, but still, it's allowed.
Human remains should not be allowed in anything.
I guess that they're thinking like skin flakes or something. I don't know.
Oh, God. That's just, no, that's not right. What are they just picking?
Most places, I don't understand that, because most of these food places, I've been in these factories, and they make you wear like these robes, gloves, hats.
Yes.
I mean, goggles.
Oh. I don't get it.
I don't either.
How can that even be safe on any level? I don't care. We're all cannibals, apparently.
Apparently.
That's gross.
I know. Let's see, there's federal levels and there's state levels, too.
Yeah. You'd think there'd be one level for everybody. It just shouldn't matter. You know? Why is there two different levels?
I don't know.
That makes no sense. Because the state says, oh, no. That can't be right. Gross, gross, gross.
All right.
That's just human remains. Oh, great. I'm really going to be looking to buy food. Ugh.
Remember years ago that lady that claimed she found a finger in her chili?
Yes, I do remember that.
And found out it was her friend's finger.
Yeah, yeah. It was something bizarre. Oh, my God. Yeah, that was like, oh. How could that even happen, you know? Oh, excuse me. Oh, my gosh. Well, Boston Market, I remember this back in February. The boneless pork from Boston Market. Glass shards and hard pieces of plastic in it. So that wasn't cool. You there, Michelle?
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, God.
I was reading something.
Oh. The Boston Market boneless pork rib patties, you know, in the meals.
Yeah.
Glass shards and hard pieces of plastic.
Oh, my God.
Over 173,000 pounds of this stuff. How can glass shards and hard plastic pieces get in there? You know, something's not right somewhere.
Yeah, that doesn't even make sense. How do you in a factory just all of a sudden have glass? But like I said, these factories also have side companies, or they rent out their factories to other, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
I'm not saying all of them, but I'm saying some of them do.
Yeah.
They make different types of products.
Wow.
In the same factory.
That's just, you think somebody would be checking that then, before they even start.
Yeah.
Glass shards and hard pieces of plastic. There's something wrong here somewhere.
I agree.
Crazy. And again, Tyson, again in January, they had to recall the chicken nuggets. Rubber pieces.
That's insanity.
Well, I don't understand how it can even get in there. Well, that's part of it, I think. What you said, but Tyson, I don't know if they would even allow anybody else in there because they make a lot of product.
Yeah, I don't think they would either. But then you never know.
That's true.
You never know.
Yeah. Wow.
What's allowed and what's not allowed with certain people.
Rubber pieces. Were they recycling tires there? I don't know. That's weird. crazy stuff. That's crazy.
It is crazy.
You know, I just... All these places. Gold medal flour. Oh, my God. Them, too.
Yeah, it's insane.
Salmonella, like, again. Never eat flour that hasn't been cooked. Okay.
Yeah. Well, not everybody in America knows the process of flour. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I guess, but I don't eat flour out of the bag. I don't know.
Well, no, I don't think anybody would, but how many times has...
Cookie dough.
For instance, a good example, when you...
Cookie dough.
When you do a cake or something, you know, something's on your hand, you just kind of, you know...
Cookie dough, especially. Cookie dough, man. Salmonella. Wow. And these are big name. These aren't your small fly-by-night companies. These are big-name companies now.
It's usually the big-name companies are the ones you're going to worry
about.
Yeah,
apparently Johnsonville, pork patties, January. It was a voluntary recall. Maybe contaminated with pieces of black rubber. Here we go with the tires again. Sounds like...
Well, I'm wondering if maybe a machine didn't break or something like part of their one of their machines.
It,
like,
that could have been,
maybe
but...
They have, like, the wheels, just parts of it came off or something. I mean, there's got to be a logical explanation as to why these things are happening.
Well, they haven't told anybody. There's been no explanations of why this stuff could be in there. Nothing that I found. Yeah. So, you know, if you're not going to tell us what's going on, oh, well, there's a surprise, right? Purdue, also gluten-free chicken nuggets. Some of them were contaminated with wood particles. There you go. More wood. Wow. Candy. Oh, my God. Bowers candies. Marshmallow candies dipped in either caramel or chocolate. Modjeska's? I don't know. Hepatitis A. Again.
Yep.
Wow. Can't trust anything.
Not really.
And even organic stuff. Organic sunflower and tahini butter. Listeria contamination.
Yeah, and for people who don't know what listeria is, because a lot of people...
That's true.
...don't. It's a bacteria. And it can actually go into your body and, like, reproduce and cause all kinds of problems.
Ugh, that's a nasty one.
It's associated with all kinds of foods.
Yeah.
People don't realize it. It comes with, especially, it's like meat and hot dogs, refrigerated plates, meat spreads, unpasteurized dairy, soft cheese, the feta, the brie, refrigerated smoked seafood, raw sprouts. I mean, it's like these are things that I'm not saying all these things have
right.
this year. I'm just saying those things are associated with
right.
it.
Right. But organic sunflower, this is organic, people. So, there you go. You're not safe either.
No. Listeria causes you to feel sick to your stomach, diarrhea. It says here, usually after a couple of days, it goes away, except for, again, with compromised people.
Yeah. Yeah.
It says the Listeria bacteria can live in soil, water, dust, animal poop, and other substances. Nice!
Oh, great, wonderful. So, to quit using manure for fertilizer, in other words, maybe. Could be part of it.
It says the untreated milk, usually the milk that hasn't been treated to kill germs. Also, other sources of outbreaks, common sources are cantaloupes, hot dogs, and soft cheeses.
There you go. Wow.
So, it's just a basic stomach flu type thing.
Yeah.
Diarrhea, nausea, achy muscles, fever. So, you may think you just got caught something from work, but you may have ate something.
Yeah.
Isn't that nice?
Oh, Del Monte Foods. This was in December. The Fiesta corn, seasoned with red and green peppers. The cans weren't sterilized properly. Could be contaminated with spoilage organisms or pathogen, including the bacteria that causes botulism. Oh, great.
Nice.
Yeah, that's a nasty one.
So, what can you do to avoid... not everybody can grow their own food, so let's say you have to get canned food. One of the best things you can do, number one, is examine the can on the outside.
You know what you do? Check your recalls. What's going on?
Yeah, check recalls, but sometimes recalls don't happen until after people are
Yeah, isn't that
it,
the truth?
Know?
Yeah, true.
So check your cans. Make sure there's no dents in the cans. Make sure the cans are in good shape. When you open the can, smell it.
Mm-hmm.
9 times out of 10, you can smell when there's something wrong with what's inside the can.
Yeah.
Once you pour out the food, check the inside of the can. Make sure there was no rips, tears, any discoloration inside the can. These are just simple things that you can do to help avoid getting sick. And if you find these things, report it right away to the store.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Now what can a store do, Denise? This is something let's say somebody finds, they bring to you a can that's discolored, and they're like, look, this stuff smells bad. you know, blah, blah, blah. What is the process that the store does?
We take it back. We give them their money back.
You give them the money back. Now, do you notify the company?
We notify the department, and they have to follow up with that.
Okay, so...
Because
so
some of it gets damaged en route. We've had trucks come in where the shit's all over the truck. Because it wasn't properly strapped down. So... You know, whoever is in charge of the grocery department has to follow up with that.
Oh, okay, to make sure it wasn't you guys, and if it wasn't, then they contact the company and say, look, this happened.
Yeah.
Okay, so so there is a process where they can kind of solve the mystery as to what happened.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, any battered cans, no. We don't usually even put them, you know, those go back, period.
As they should.
Yeah. Because we have our own warehouses, Kroger does, and their own products that they make, so. Now, again, I don't know if their factories or whatever, you know, run out. I don't know. It's a good question. But, you know, but some of the stuff, you wouldn't believe how some of the stuff comes in on the truck. Like I said, we've had several trucks that they couldn't take half of it. We had to send it back because it was so damaged.
Yeah.
It's not strapped properly, or they got it up too high and it all fell over, all that good stuff. It's wonderful. So.
Ew, gross. Okay, well, there's apparently a new trend among people, kids, things like that. They are doing things like taking the lids off ice cream and licking them.
Yeah.
They are going in stores and doing stuff like Listerine, things like that. They're opening the carton, drinking some, we're swishing it out of their mouth and spitting it back in the bottle.
Oh. Like, you know what?
Make sure your plastic's on the bottle, people. Don't get it if it isn't.
Also, you know what they do too? They'll open you know those, you have to take the seal off type thing? They'll punch holes in it. You won't know it till you get it home. But we take it that back too. Because it's got to be, because sometimes you get, you know, a bunch of the same item. They're just punching holes in the seal. I don't know what they're doing with it, but don't take a chance. Take it back.
Punching holes in what seal?
You know, like that seal they have, like over ketchup or mustard or seasonings?
Yeah.
Okay, they're punching holes in them.
And so putting God knows what in the
kitchen.
Yeah,
we don't. Yeah, if anything, you know, again, it could be just doing it just to, because you can't use. People are going to be bringing it back, of course. If you get, you know, we start getting, like one time was a seasoning. A bunch of people, you know, maybe half a dozen people brought it back because the seals were punctured. There were big holes in them.
Oh wow!
Yeah, so. Yeah, be careful. If as soon as you open that cap, if that seal is in any way messed up, just take it right back. Don't even bother. Because you don't know what they've done to it.
That is insane.
It is. It was a seasoning. I can't remember what it was. But it had like a paper plastic seal type thing where you have to peel it back. And there were holes punched in the tops of the seals, so no, it does not come that way. So any seal,
no, it does not.
So don't just take it right back. Have them open the top for you then too, just make sure that seal is intact.
Also with sodas, this is another thing that's going on, is you're opening like the 2-liter sodas or the bottles, and they're just taking a sip and putting the lids back on.
Well, you can tell if that lid's been tampered with.
Yeah, if it feels like it's separated at all, do not use it.
No, no. Yeah, that you can tell because it's got snap open and it breaks that. So if that seal around there is in any way broken, do not buy it at all. Let somebody know. We'll take, you know, they'll take care of it. That's crazy.
that is.
Are they bored?
What people don't understand, these kids, is they can actually face up to 20 years for doing these kinds of things.
Yeah, it's putting the public in danger.
Yes. And there is, like, federal laws against this stuff, and you will... 20 years. So think about that.
Most, and most stores, if you bring the product, like, if there's something like that, yeah, it can actually go back. They have videotape. Usually.
Yeah, this is the day of Big Brother, people.
Yeah, we'll catch you.
You can't do anything without being recognized.
Yep.
So, it's not always just these big evil companies
right.
that are... Sometimes it's human error. Sometimes it's people doing things on purpose.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, and like we said, make sure your food's cooked. Examine your stuff, you know. Don't just take it home, open it, and start going like it's cool because it's not.
And please, don't leave a package like ground beef or something. Don't leave it in your refrigerator for 5 days. You have to take it home and freeze it. Okay?
Right.
Yeah, because they brought it back.
Unless you're going to use it that day.
Yeah. We just took it out of the refrigerator. And it has this used-by date. I said, did you freeze it? No. You can't do that.
No.
You can't do that. You can't leave meat like that or fish or anything in your refrigerator for 5 days and thinking it's going to be good.
My God.
Yeah. Bring back home ec. Oh, sorry, guys. Oh, my God. But, yeah, you know, if you don't know, look it up. The day of Google. I mean, come on. And people bring the stuff back, but they don't know they have to freeze it. You know, not leave it in your refrigerator for a week. No, it's not going to be good.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
Well, another thing, too, is... Like you said, sometimes it's just human error.
Yeah.
You have to be smart. You have to watch what you're doing. And like I said, in an ideal world, you'd have your own farm and...
Oh, yeah.
You know, raise your own cows and pigs, and you would have a field full of vegetables, but that's just not reality for most of us,
yeah.
So...
Yeah, exactly. A lot of organic. Watch your almond butter stuff. There was a recall on that. And it's in December, and it was tested positive for listeria.
What was this?
Almond butter. Organic.
Oh, wow.
Organic sunflower butter and almond butter. Organic. It came back, both of them came back positive for listeria. Positive. They were tested, so. And the Best Buy date was 2020. So, anybody has that? That either throw it away or take it back.
That's insane.
It's organic. This is organic stuff now. This isn't your, you know, a lot of people are going to organics. You got to watch there too. It's not all, you know, just so wonderful.
Right.
Yeah.
Because.
The tahini.
Okay.
That tahini, a lot of people are using that.
Yeah. They are.
There was a big recall on that. Salmonella. In your hummus.
It's everything. It's like I said, you got to check every one of your food. You got to check the recalls. Okay, what is the actual website for the recalls?
You can just put it, you know, Google recalls, but you can also go to, there's so much information on that. You can go to ohio.gov, Ohio Department of Health, ODH, and get recalls.
Let's see here.
All your
there should be an actual website for the food recalls.
Foodsafety.gov. Recalls and outbreaks.
Yep.
Foodsafety.gov. I'm going to put that in here.
Yep.
Food safety.
Okay, and here's one to the, the www.fsis.usda.gov.
There you go.
And that's for the USDA, and they will show you all the recalls. The last one was frozen and dual sausage products due to possible foreign matter contamination. They don't even say what the foreign matter is.
Yeah.
That was on June 24th. They also have recalls of stuff that was abused during transport, like what you were talking about.
Yep.
So, this one's a really good site, so.
Put that on there.
Yep, I will actually, we'll put it right on our site here. I'm going to copy the link, and I'm going to put it right on the show's.
There you go.
Thread here.
Yeah.
I can get to it, I swear.
And it'll tell you what stores, too. On that foodsafety.gov, it'll say, from Walmart, from Costco, Trader Joe's, Kroger, Aldi's, Meijer's, all of them.
Yeah.
So, you know, depending on where you brought it from, it'll be able to tell you. So, absolutely. And be careful. There's recalls of dietary supplements also.
Isn't that crazy?
Yes.
Vitamins, all kinds of stuff.
Yeah. Could be mislabeled, may present a health hazard.
There we go.
Yeah.
I got that one on there. So, definitely check that out. That has like a whole list of different things. And
there you go. Here's another one. Keurig Dr. Pepper announces voluntary withdrawal of unflavored Pentaphil mineral spring water. That does not meet FDA bottled water standards. You know, drink your water from home. What?
Yeah.
What are they doing to make that water better than what we get? You know, if you have a filter in your fridge, I do, for filtered water. Why?
Yeah. We can get those ones that go right on your faucet,
yes,
too.
Absolutely. Why are you buying water?
For like $35-$40, it hooks right up to your faucet, and it filters your water for almost, 60 days, depending on how big your household is, maybe even longer. And you don't have to buy the
bottled water. Dear
God. And the filters are about $7.
Yeah. Which is, a lot of times, is about 2 cases of water. So, think about that. Think about that. So, and they even have a place for appliances and toys and all that for safety. So, check it out. Absolutely. So, you know, be safe with your food. Always check your seals. Always check, if it smells decent or, looks funny, whatever the case is. Don't eat it. Take it back.
I'm looking at this thing here, one of these recalls. It says, misbranding an undeclared allergen.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I saw
Thanks
that.
Thanks for nothing, USDA.
Yeah. 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 Safety and inspection. Yeah. I'm like, what? Yeah. Current recalls. It's like, wow. That's crazy. That's just insane. Current recalls on the USDA.
Yeah. And then, like I said, and then you also have human error, which you do at home.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of people, like I said, people will leave their food on the stove.
Yeah. No.
For hours on end. And I know that some people do this, and they say, I've done it my whole life and it's fine. But a lot of people have done it and they've died. So think about that one for a second. Do you really want to be the one who died?
Yeah. Unless, you can't put it away after it's been left out like that. No. Don't do that. Don't take it to lunch. So, yeah. Not a good thing at all. Especially meat. Yeah. You don't want to do that.
Well, yeah. I mean, anything.
Yeah.
You could eggs. Something. If it's on the stove for, more than so long, you gotta toss it.
Yeah.
I know it sucks. I hate throwing away food, too, but I would rather throw it away than to you know, all of a sudden you fall asleep, and 4 hours later you wake up and your food's still on the stove, you're like, you know.
Yeah, not a good thing.
And like I said, there's people out there who be like, I've left my chili on the stove overnight and it was fine. Okay.
Yeah, no. Oh, my God.
Don't do it.
Oh, my God, no. No. Absolutely not. Wow. Yeah. I want to know more about that human remain thing, actually.
I know.
That's so gross. I'm like, oh, that just, ooh. Human remains decompose, people. I mean.
I think what they're talking about is like skin flakes, that kind of thing. I don't know. I'm guessing that's what they're talking about. Because, you know, like, they don't cover their faces and stuff can come off, you know. I think that's, I mean, hold on.
Let me, yeah, I'm looking that up.
I'm trying to get back to that site.
Oh, yeah, here. 11 totally disgusting things they let into your food. Oh, great. Some rat hair.
Oh,
with
okay.
Peanut butter. Ew.
Yep, like right here it says in a 16-ounce jar of peanut butter, the FDA will allow up to 136 insect fragments, 4 rodent hairs. The FDA won't allow more than 3% of fillets to contain copepod parasitic crustaceans that dwell in fish flesh.
Oh. Oh, this is not good.
Yeah.
The addition of rat, let's see, upon ordering a burger in a fast food chain, diners might have already come to terms with the fact there is a very, very slim chance of horse meat. But the additions of rat and human DNA could be harder to swallow. A new study from U.S.-based food testing company Clear Labs has discovered from a sample of 250 burgers, 2 cases of meat and vegetarian products, 3 burgers with rat DNA, and 1 case of human DNA.
Yep.
Yeah, thanks, no.
But that's what they're talking about. Yeah. So those certain amounts are allowed of different things.
It says, really what consumers may not know is that some amounts of human and rat DNA fall within acceptable regulatory range. There should be no regulatory range for that at all.
Agreed.
No. Dear God. Why? That is just gross.
That there
should be, that none of it should, that should not be allowed, period. Oh, excuse me. Wow. That's just gross. I don't care. Oh, my God. Yep. Mostly your burgers and what they allow in your food. That's just unacceptable. I'm sorry.
I agree, but they do allow it, so.
Why, how do they?
You gotta cook your food, people.
I don't think I'll eat a burger again, I swear. Ugh.
Your food.
Yeah, honestly. I mean, that no acceptable amount of rat or human DNA should be allowed. I'm sorry. That's just not right. How do they figure it's safe? I don't know, but
I'm guessing like stuff floats in the air or something. I don't know.
Okay, that's fine, but you know, how do rat shit get in there? That's what I want to know.
Yeah.
And let them run around in it. That's okay. It's all good. No, it is not all good. I don't understand that at all. Ugh. That just thinking about it turns my, ugh. Yeah, no. Nope. But I'm not going to raise cattle, so darn it.
Well, and that's the thing. That's like I tell people all the time. It's like most of us don't have that opportunity. Do you know what I mean?
Yes. Yeah. I do.
It's like we just absolutely do not have that, you know. Most of us live in cities, but there are things you can do. Okay. You can grow things in your home. Container gardens, if as long as you have a window that has some direct sunlight that can come in, you can grow some vegetables. You can grow tomatoes. You can grow cucumbers. You can even grow the little upside down strawberries in your windows.
Oh, there you go.
There's so many things that you can do that you can grow zucchinis. Potatoes. Oh my God, potatoes are like the easiest things to grow ever. All you need are a plastic pot and then a terracotta pot. Cut holes in the one. Plant your potatoes in there and then put it inside the terracotta pot. Trust me, you will have potatoes in no time. There are so many things that you can do, even in an apartment. If you have a balcony, oh my God, you're golden. You can have containers out there galore.
There you go. Yeah.
You can grow trellis. You can grow lettuce in old milk cartons. You don't need fancy equipment. You don't need to have all this. Like you go to a greenhouse, they'll tell you, oh, you need this and this.
No, you don't. No.
You need a container, which can mean anything. It could be a old hollowed out milk carton. It could be a 2-liter bottle. You can do just about any. You need some dirt, some fertilizer, some water, some sunlight, and just something to help keep the bugs. You're fine.
There you go.
You can grow lettuce. You can grow your own cucumbers. There are a lot of things that you can do to do it yourself. So definitely, as far as vegetables go, you can do that yourself. Now meat,
that's a whole nother ball game.
What I do suggest though is with meat, try to find an actual butcher in your town.
There you go.
You still have them in places.
We have one here in the area, so.
Or go online and see if there's anybody that has local farms that are selling the meat and stuff like that. Like, there's a place here that does that, so.
There you go. Yeah, butchers, absolutely. We do have one. And actually, it's a lot cheaper than your stores.
Yeah, and then, because a lot of the people don't, let me tell you a little secret, okay? Like, when you go to a store and they've got those meats that are already seasoned, what that is old freaking meat that's ready to be done, and they season it to cover up any abnormalities in it, so that way when you buy it. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm not saying every single store does, but I know for a fact there's a huge, big chain, and I'm not going to mention their name, but they do it, because I have a friend who works there, and they do that. Yes.
Ooh. That's just gross.
It is gross.
So there you go. What the heck?
Buy those discounted meats that are ready to be...
Yeah, no.
Freeze them. So it's like those ones that, what I'm talking about? Like,
yeah.
They're new on that day. You can put them in the freezer right away.
Yeah, we have.
Or freeze by that date. That's what it means.
Yes, absolutely. But we've had people have come back with that. Oh, it's not good. What did you think you were getting? Most of they do not follow what they're supposed to do, and they're bringing it back because it's not good. What does it say on there?
Right.
I'm like, ugh. Why? Then don't buy that. This is what happens. It just amazes me sometimes.
Oh, it does me too. I can't stand. Absolutely cannot stand some people and their stupidity.
There's a lot of it, believe me. It's crazy. They want to keep it. They don't want to eat it right away. But for at least freeze it. Do something. Don't bring it back 3 days later. It was discounted anyway for a reason. You can't hang on to it like that. Honestly. Especially and sushi. How can raw fish be good for you? I don't know.
I mean, I know a lot of people who eat it and they're fine, so I don't.
I
personally don't. It's just not a preference of mine, but
yeah.
I do know people that eat it and they're fine.
Yeah.
I think a lot of it is people will buy this sushi, and I've seen this, but they'll get it in a container for their lunch.
Yeah.
They'll leave it out on the counter or something, yeah. And then they eat it, and they get sick, and they're like, oh, I got bad sushi. It's like, no,
no.
You've got stupidity is what you got.
Yeah, you can't leave it out, no. I like the all like a vegetable sushi, they call it, like a vegetable
yeah.
roll or something. That's good. That's good for me. But some of that, I'm like, ooh, yeah, no.
Yeah, like I said, sushi's not my thing, but I know a lot of people eat it and they're fine with. But like I said, 9 times
yes.
out of 10,
yeah.
the ones who get sick from sushi
yeah.
are the ones who grab it for lunch. Or, they leave it out. Or,
you know, and get your sushi from a reputable place. Don't get it at your corner gas station. Okay.
Right.
Okay. Just a thought there.
Don't buy it from the lady in the parking lot
yeah.
that has a cooler.
Yeah, no. Don't be doing that, you know.
Although, let me tell you, that only counts unless it's the tamale lady. If the tamale lady's selling tamales in the parking lot, you buy that crap. It's good.
There you go. There you go.
Oh, my God. I love tamales.
They are good. Mm.
Yes.
But
they don't have tamale
yeah,
ladies.
Yeah, just what we're saying, use some common sense here, okay?
Yes, please. And I get off track there, start talking about tamales. Anyway.
Yeah. Yeah, just, you know, use some common sense, just some safety tips. You know, check your stuff. Make sure you're washing your fruits and vegetables before you eat them. You know.
You can use a vinegar wash.
There you go.
If you're tripping about putting, you know, some of them say to put a drop of dishwashing liquid on it, wash it off and rinse it. A lot of people trip on that, so use like a cup of vinegar in your sink, fill it up, and then put your vegetables in there for a couple minutes, wash it around, and it'll kill everything. So, on your, you know, on the outside.
Right.
So.
Right.
But yeah, Google vinegar wash for your vegetables. It's really good.
There you go. I mean, there's some simple things you can do to, you know, prevent this stuff from happening. So, just, you know, check your recall, see what's going on, because...
Check your recalls, and your foodborne illness is because of your lack of attention.
Yes.
Like I said, people bring potato salad to, or another thing, they'll have pre-made burgers, and they'll
yeah.
leave them sitting out in the sun with flies getting all over them.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Before I'll put them on the grill, it's like, no, you keep them in that damn cooler until you're ready to cook them.
Yes.
And then get them out and start cooking them. Any ones that you're not cooking, put them back in the cooler.
There you go. Absolutely. Hot dogs, hamburgers, you know, whatever meat you're cooking.
Like I said, there's just common sense factors that people are not following.
Yep.
And they're getting sick, and then they're blaming the meat companies, and they're blaming...
Yeah, it's not them, yeah, come to find out. Yeah, I left it out for 4 hours. Yeah, well, that could have something to do with it.
Yeah, one of the biggest, like I said, the biggest common mistakes is that is leaving the meat out.
Yeah.
You have potato salad that gets left
yes.
out, deviled eggs. Oh
deviled
my God,
eggs, people. Yes, yes.
There is a very simple trick that you can do with deviled eggs, and that is just simply put down some paper towels and put some ice on top of that and put your deviled egg tray on top of it.
Yeah, or you can, you know what works really well to put ice in? Just get a foil pan.
Yeah.
That is so simple. And you don't have to throw it. Just
ice.
Yeah, put ice in the bottom, put your stuff on top. Real simple. And make sure it's covered, though, too. So.
Yes. Keep the flies away.
Yeah.
So
just simple things you can do.
Potato salad.
Yeah.
Like I said, there's so many things. Like, a lot of people will bring pies even on these outings.
Yeah.
And with cream topping.
Yeah, yeah.
And they leave it out in the sun.
Ugh.
It goes bad. People get sick.
Yep, absolutely. Absolutely. So just...
Oh, please.
Yeah,
please.
A couple simple things you can do to prevent it. So, there you go.
Yeah, just like you said, you know, if you can't prepare ahead of time, use the foil pan. If you didn't prepare ahead of time, seriously, it works. Put some paper towels down on their napkins, down on the picnic table. Put some ice on top of that and just set your tray right on top of it. The ice won't last long, but it'll last long enough for you to be serving.
There you go. There you go. That works. That works.
Let's see.
What else you got? Anything?
No, just drinks too. Try to keep
oh,
drinks
yeah.
Tonight.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
So,
yeah, I didn't think of drinks.
Just a little common sense will take you a long way with keeping yourself healthy.
Oh, absolutely.
Simple common sense.
Yeah.
It's not always the companies.
I know, right? It's like, wow.
Or if you open up a jar of something and you see stuff under that's not supposed to be there, don't eat it anyways.
No. No.
Take it back to the store.
Yeah. Oh, it'll be okay. Yeah. No, it won't be okay. Just take it back.
Exactly.
Take you maybe 5-10 minutes. That's all. So, better than eating something that's going to make you ill for a week.
Exactly. All right. So, I think that's about it for now. Just like you said, common sense, pay attention, go to the recall site, see what's been recalled, check your cabinet.
There you
check
go.
The numbers.
Yes.
And you'll be fine.
Yeah. Yep.
Not fine, but, you know, you'll be better off.
Absolutely. Absolutely. You know, if a seal is broken, check all that. Don't use it anyway. Oh, it's okay. No, it's not. From these kids, what you've been saying, yeah. No, it's not okay. Take it back. You don't know what's going on.
Being jerks.
Yeah. That, God, you know, are they that bored? Wow.
Probably.
That's so... No, not a good thing.
Yeah.
Yep, not a good thing. But anyway, hopefully we gave you some good tips and ideas what to do to prevent yourself from getting sick from foods and what to look for, right?
And even to grow your own food.
Yep.
To avoid some of this stuff altogether.
There you go. There you go. And even watch your organics. Obviously.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
Sometimes organic doesn't mean organic. It just means that they, you know, grew it in a different way or something, you know.
Yeah.
People don't understand that organic doesn't always mean organic.
Yeah, you got that right. That's exactly
because
right.
Because the government's version of organic and what you have in your mind are two different things.
Absolutely two different things. That's it. That's it in a nutshell. There you go.
So...
Okay.
Well, that's about it for me. You got anything?
No, I'm going to take some medicine and go to sleep.
Oh, my gosh, yes. Yeah. Get yourself well.
Yep. I'm going to try.
And then we'll actually do Encounters and Ecto this Saturday.
Yeah, we'll do that. I can't believe I said that. Oh, my God.
I was like, did she just say that? I was like, she did.
I don't know what I was thinking. Honest to God, I was like, oh, crap. You know, what the hell was I doing?
I was like, dude, it's quite a bit of issue.
I'm like, oh, shit. Yeah, damn it. Oh, my God. I am so sorry I did that. Oh, my God. I can't believe I did that. I blame it on the meds.
There you
and
go.
And the cold medicine. My brain is, like, foggy as hell, so I don't know. I don't know why. I almost wrote it in there that way, too, but I caught myself. But I didn't catch myself when I announced it. I apologize.
Yeah, we all good.
Duh. So, yeah, that does it for tonight. I'm headed to bed. That is for sure. I'm
all right, y'all tune in. We're gonna be having some good shows this week.
Oh yeah,
on this week. I should be on Saturday. We'll see. We're gonna have the freaks. I'm doing it different today.
All right, I could probably do that. Freaks in the basement.
Freaks.
Yeah, this cold helps.
On Friday, you'll have Hollywood Review.
Yeah.
Are you going to be doing the Fear the Walking Dead this week?
Yes, Tuesday. Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow, yeah, duh. See, I don't even know what day it is. So, yeah, tomorrow, yes.
So we got a lot of good stuff coming up. Check it out.
Absolutely. And
check it out. I got some pretty good ghost stories for Saturday. And I know Denise is going to be talking about, what are you going to be talking about, sir? The nightmare stuff?
Yeah. Yes, yes.
I'm going to write the dark thread, by the way.
Yeah, and it's that time of year where, you know, it's been a year and it still freaks me out. So. We'll talk about that. Yeah.
Yes.
Totally freaks me out. So, yeah,
that
we'll talk about that.
Freaks me out when you tell me. It gave me chills from hell. I was like, don't go outside today.
Yeah. So, yeah, I'm like, ooh, lock all the doors, shut all the drapes. I'm like, ah. Yeah, it's kind of freaky, but we'll get to that Saturday. So,
Yes.
yeah. So, everybody have a good night. Thanks for listening. Stay safe.
And you can also get our shows at KBLP LLC on Facebook, KBLP LLC 4 on YouTube. You can go to Planet B period O period B period on Facebook. We also have the links there, some information, good information for you guys to go just check out different survival stuff. We also go to Survival Wolves, very good site. Mike Ronan's there. He has some really good stuff. And
Yes.
Innate Survivalist and Conflicted What Would You Do scenarios. So.
Excellent pages. Excellent. Whoa, you could do one of those commercials where you talk real fast about the stuff, the fine print. You read the fine print thing. Yeah.
Yeah, where they tell you that your butt's gonna fall off from taking that medicine, but they say it really fast, you're gonna pop me,
There you go. You're good at that. Yeah, excellent. No, excellent Facebook pages. Check them out for sure. I think you'll be pleasantly surprised. Very good. Very good. So, yep. We're gonna put you on the next ad for the vitaminogen.
Hey, this product might make you feel better, might make your butt fall out. You never know.
Absolutely. Yep. There you go. And you heard it here first, so there you go. Okay. Yep. So have a good night, y'all. Thanks for listening. Peace out, y'all.
Night.